I actually got involved in skating because my family owns roller skating rinks in Michigan. So,
how was your childhood?
My parents built the rink here in Woodhaven when I was just before I was born. So I actually started skating when I was 11 months old. And they had the smallest pair of skates for me, and we actually still have them today, and they fit my little niece. So we actually, a lot of the little people in our family started skating before they were 1 year old.
I think I was on the schedule for work at 11 years old.
I grew up figure skating and speed skating and playing hockey on roller skates. And I did that until I was 24. I did competitions nationally and internationally.
What was it like growing up with Skateland?
I started skating when I was really young, and that was basically my whole entire life growing up. But it was really neat because I'm the last of seven children, so I got to be around my brothers and sisters and my mom and my dad since this was a family-owned business. But we also, you know, not only we're also like in the sport of roller skating, so it was fun because I got to do figure skating, hockey, speed skating, and now I'm doing derby today. So it's just been a part of my life since I can remember.
Did you dream of being in the Olympics growing up as a child?
So roller skating wasn't in the Olympics all while I was growing up, although I always had the dream of competing at an international level, and I actually started going overseas when I was just 15 years old. So it was kind of always in the back of my mind to compete on that kind of platform, you know, at the highest level possible. I had actually quit skating because my mother got ill when I was just 22 years old.
She lost her biggest fan, her father.
She lost her dad, Bill, to a heart attack in 2001. And now her mom, Claire, was sick. Multiple myeloma, a form of cancer. As the games drew near, Claire's cancer got worse. Still, she planned the entire family's trip to Vancouver, even before Jill had earned a spot on the team.
Before the Olympic trials, she made the reservations for the condo in Vancouver. She knew. I told her it was a little bit of pressure.
But as is often the case, mom was right.
After the last World Cup, I got to call my mom. I said, Mom, I'm an Olympian. And she said, Honey, I'm so proud of you. And that was like my moment, you know?
5 days later, her mother was gone.
If it's meant to be, then keep me here, you know, just give me some sign that I'm supposed to be here. And within one weekend, I got an apartment, a roommate, a pair of skates, a set of blades, and a coach within one weekend, 2 days. And I was meant to be there.
And then when she had got a little better, I got the opportunity to try ice skating, and I had never tried ice skating before.
Did you think you'd make it to the Olympics?
Making the Olympic team was always a far shot off in my mind, and I never thought I'd would make it, but it was always, you know, when I moved to Milwaukee and, you know, got a little bit better at it, you know, month by month, it became more of a reality.
What was your favorite part about the Olympics?
My favorite part was watching my family celebrate and cheer for me and enjoy the whole experience. You know, they had their faces painted. They posted pictures of, you know, all their adventures in Vancouver. And, you know, the second time around it was in Russia, so my family didn't get to go. However, just the village in general was set up so differently. And because a lot of families didn't go, I was able to get a lot of tickets for some of my friends that were able to attend. And so I think I got to enjoy all of the events a lot more. I got to go to all the hockey games, all the figure skating events. I got to see, games like USA versus Canada in hockey, you know, on some occasions. And so I think just personally I enjoyed it a little better, whereas the first time around I got to see my family really celebrate. So both were very different.
What were the Olympics like?
When people think of the Olympics, I think they think, you know, that it's very glorious and glamorous. That is actually only during the Olympics. As far as training for it, it's actually like the military. You wake up, you eat, you go to practice for a few hours, you come back home, and your whole day is prepared hour by hour. It's kind of like putting a puzzle together, but over the span of 4 years. So it is a very draining process, but you know, being able to make it to the Olympics is probably the most rewarding thing in an athlete's life. So I don't know, it's a little bit hard to describe. I've been to two Olympics and both of them were very different.
What made you decide to do derby?
The first when I started derby, I thought it might just help out my training for speed skating. I'm obviously very good on my roller skates and I have a big skill set. And so, you know, I just thought it would be something fun to kind of try. And I like to use, you know, different parts of roller skating, whether it's, you know, going to league meets for the inline skaters or watching kids or just playing hockey. You know, basically I like to view training as also playtime, you know, just so it always keeps it a little fresh. But I'm finding out you know you can go pretty far in roller derby and there's international competitions, and it's kind of hard to let that competitive edge go. You know, just quitting speed skating altogether. And I think this will, you know, I don't know how far I'll go, but I think it'll be pretty entertaining in the process.
What's your favorite position?
Okay, so when I first started roller derby, I actually didn't know any of the rules. I even got kicked out of my first match just because I had too many penalties. So I kind of, you know, didn't know what my strengths would be other than I'm just really good at the skating part. So I tried both jamming and blocking, and I just found that, you know, jamming's probably, you know, being the jammer and scoring the points is probably, you know, where I'll end up. But I like to play all positions just to be a well-rounded athlete in general.
In one word, how would you describe Jill as a skater?
She's a serious skater.
Artistic.
How would you describe in one word Jill as a person?
Fabulous.
She's pretty ridiculous.
Hallelujah. Girl, sit you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown.